Hi, my name is Chris Lemp, and I'm from the Dynamic Drum School, and today is part 5 of the quarter note drum beat series. Today we're going to teach you how to play the classic You Dropped a Bomb on Me by the Gap Band. And this is a great song for any drummer to learn, but I love to teach it to beginners because, for one, it's just a quarter note drum beat. Two, it's a little bit faster, so it kind of pushes you out of your comfort zone. And the third reason is it really reinforces four measure phrases, because you're going to play the crash at the beginning of the four measures, and you're going to play a simple fill at the end of the four measures. So by practicing this and playing along with the song, you eventually just start to naturally feel those four measure phrases. So I believe the drummer is Raymond Calhoun, great funk drummer from the 70s. And basically we're going to show you a simple fill at the beginning that you would have learned in the third video, adding the crash and then playing just a quarter note drum beat fill. Then we're going to show you the actual three fills that the drummer plays for the song. And then at the end, we're going to show you some variations that you can just add for fun. So hope you have fun. And if you haven't seen the first four parts, be sure to watch those first, because it will help you learn how to play the song. So the first thing to try with the video is just playing the crash cymbal on count one, and then playing the quarter note drum beat for four measures, and playing the drum beat where the bass drum is only on the one and the three. This will make it a little bit easier at first. And then you just repeat that every four measures. So that would sound like this. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Two, two, three, four. Three, two, three, four. Four, two, three, four. The next thing is just, let me just show you what that would sound like with the song. One, two, three, four. Two. Three. Four, two, three, four. Two. So that can be really fun just to play that, practice that throughout the song. I did that at 75% of this original speed. Once you can do that, try it at full speed. The next thing is to do what we learned in the third video, where you do the same thing, but you add a fill every fourth measure. So this is what it will sound like with the song. One, two, three, four. Two. Once you get that, then you can add the bass drum on beats 2 and 4, which you learn in the third video, where you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you're just going to do the same thing with the crash every four measures. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4.
Two, three, four. Two. Three. Drum fill. One, two, three, four. Two. Three. One, two, three, four.
You were the girl.
Two.
My world.
Three.
Drum fill.
Three.
You were the first for me.
to the main fill. Let's slow it way down. And the first way I'm going to show you is to actually sing the rhythm. So that rhythm would be bop, bop, up. Another way to do it is to say a word that has three syllables. So one that would work would be hamburger. Another thing, if you're a vegetarian, you could say strawberry, strawberry. Then let's just show you at the end of the beat, you're going to play this fill. So we'll go like this. One, two, three, strawberry. And I think an easier way to learn it is just play beat four. So I'm going to click and count the first three beats. One, two, three, strawberry. One, two, three, hamburger. One, two, three, bop, bada. One, two, three, strawberry. Now let's put the whole measure together with the beat. A little bit slower. One, two, ready, go. One, two, three, bop, bada. One, two, three, strawberry. One, two, three, hamburger. One, two, three, bop, bada. Now let's play the full four measures. One, a little bit faster. One, two, ready, go. One, two, three, four, two, two, three, four, three, two, three, four, four, two, three, hamburger. So if you have trouble, just play it, just the fill at the end. Once you get it, add the crash, do the whole full four measures, and then try to build up the speed. All right, so let me show you the second fill of the song. This, you're going to play that first fill all the way, every four measures, until 2 minutes and 35 seconds in, there's a new chorus that starts. And on the fourth measure of that chorus, there's an extra bass drum hit. It goes like this. One, two, boom, two, bop, bada, boom. First way. One, two, boom, two, bop, bada, boom. So boom, do bop, bada, boom. So we go like this. One, two, boom, do bop, bada, boom. So notice beats one, two, and three are the same. One, two, three, and then there's an extra bass drum right before the snare. So one, two, boom, do bop, bada, boom. And I'm going to show you right away what the actual notation is. But try, if you don't know what that is yet, don't worry. Just learn this by ear. So again, one, two, ready, go. One, two, boom, do bop, bada, boom. Again, one, two, boom, do bop, bada, boom. All right. So now I'm gonna play the four measures. Three, four, one, two, three, four, two, two, three, four, three, two. One, two, boom, bop, bada, boom. All right, the third fill, before I get to that, I forgot to mention the second fill, you play it a second time towards the end of the song. And if you go to 4 minutes and 28 seconds in, there's the beginning. This is the outro section. You're going to hit the crash, do the same thing, and then in the fourth measure, you'll do that fill. All right, now let's show you the very last fill. This is the third fill of the song. And this one, if you go 4 minutes and 51 seconds in, you're going to have the beginning of that four measure section. And the last four measures, you're going to have this new fill. And it's kind of right as the song starts to fade away. So let's do the same thing. Let's do it with singing. Let's come up with some words, and then we'll do the actual counting. So let me play it first. Three, four. One, two, three, four. Two, two, three, four. Three, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, one. Really cool fill. So it's a little bit harder to add the bass drum, so you could just do one, two, deca, 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 boom. If you can do that, then you can add the bass drum at the beginning of every four. One, two, deca, 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 down. So another cool way is to actually come up with some words. You could say watermelon, watermelon, or you could also say avocado. Avocado. You could say one word and then the second word, because you're going to do this twice. So watermelon, avocado. So with the whole beat, it'd be one, two, watermelon, avocado. Or you could say the same word twice. Avocado, avocado. Or watermelon, watermelon. So let me play the beat. 3, 4. 1, 2. Watermelon, avocado. 1, 2. Watermelon, avocado. Watermelon, avocado. So that's pretty fun. Now I want to show you the actual counting, the actual rhythm. And the main rhythm is an eighth note and then 2/16. And you'd hit it on beat 4 with the hi-hat, snare, and bass. 4 and a. Now you're going to put it just on beat 4. So with the whole beat. 1, 2, 3, 4 and a. Notice I'm hitting 4, 4 and a. So again, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, and a 1. So let's try it hitting the crash at the beginning. 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, and a 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 1. Now a little bit faster, and we'll do all 4 measures. 1, 2, ready, go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 2, 3, 4. 3, 2, 3, 4. 4, 2, 3, 4. 1. So let me play it once with the counting. 1, 2, 3, and a 4, and a 1. So it's just the last 16th of beat 3. 3 and a 4. 3 and a 4. And then you're going to hit the hi-hat with there. 3 and a 4 and a 1. So beats 1, 2, and 3 are the same. 1, 2, 3 and a 4 and a 1. So you can think of it as the first 16th and the last 16th of beat 3. 3 and a 4. So the whole measure. 3. I'll just repeat it. 1, 2. 3 and a 4 and a 1, 2, 3 and a 4 and a 1, 2, 3 and a 4 and a 1, 2, 3 and a 4 and a 1, 1, 2, and then 3 and a 4 and a 1. So starting on beat 3, you have 4/16ths, and then on beat 4, you have 4 more 16ths. So 1e and a 2e and a 3e and a 4e and a 1, 2, 3e and a 4e and a 1, 2, 3e and a 4e and a 1. Now I want to teach you the intro fill. 2 quick snare hits. We also call this a pickup. It's just 2 quick snare hits leading into the song. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And then the song starts. I thought it'd be good to teach you the other fill first, and then this will be easy once you know how to play that. Because you notice you're just leaving out the 4 and then the 2 quick hits. So with the counting first, 1, 2, 3, 4, and a 1. With the singing, 1, 2, 3, 4, ba-da-boom. So I'm going to do that and start the song. 1, 2, 3, 4. In the song, you'll listen for the synthesizer and then a little bit of laughing, and then that comes in. So now I wanted to show you some other fill variations that you can use. So these are fills that the drummer doesn't play. So the first thing that you can try is take one of the fills you already learned and just move it to a different drum. So quick variation of the first one, you go 1, 2, 3, 4, and a 1. Instead of doing the quick 2 hits on the snare, move it to a floor tom or to another tom-tom. So once again, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, and a 1, 2, 3, 4, and a 1. That's an easy one. Another variation with the third fill, we did the 3e and a 4e and a. That's an easy one just to move around the toms. You could go 3e and a 4e and a, or 3e and a 4e and a, let me just play real slow, and I'm just going to repeat that measure with different fill variations. 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, and a 4. So let me show you a couple other ones that could be fun to try. Basically, just adding two more eighth notes on beats 3 and then doing that same first fill. So it'll go like this. 1, 2, 3, and 4, and a 1, 2, 3, and 4, and a 1. A variation of that, you just do the 3 and 4, and a same thing. Move the last two to a different drum. 1, 2, 3, and 4, and a 1. Another cool fill would be basically to do the second fill and then add a flam on beat 4. So real slow. 1, 2, 3, and 4, and a 1. So I basically did the same thing. 1, 2, 3, and a 4. Instead of that, I did a flam. So same thing. I'm just assuming you already know what a flam is, just to show you some new ideas. So 1, 2, 3, and a flam, and a 1, 2, 3, and a 4. So you're doing the same thing with the bass. 3 and a 4 and a 1. A little faster. 1, 2, 3 and a 4 and a 1. That's the old way. 3 and a flam. Now let's move it around. All right, I hope you had fun learning that song. If you have any questions, if there was any part of it that you didn't understand, please leave a comment below and I'll be happy to answer that. Hopefully we can help you figure out what to play. So definitely I recommend for absolute beginners, just try playing the beat. Then if you can add the crash for step 2, then step 3, try to do the quarter note fills that we learned in the third video. Then try to learn the actual fills once you can do that. And then anybody that's been playing drums, like I said, this is a great song just to try to learn note for note what the drummer's doing. One is going to be just a basic chart of just adding the crash and then the simple fill, but just so you can get a basic layout of the song, the orders of the verse and the chorus. Then there's going to be a second chart that's actually note for note of what the original drummer did. That way you can learn exactly what was played. And then I'll also do a bonus where you can see the notation of the extra fills that I did, and I'll add a few more. So if you enjoyed it, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. I'm going to add a few more songs. Like I said, the Running Down a Dream and Let's Go Crazy. But I started thinking, too, that there might be a couple more fun songs. There's Freedom by Pharrell that's from Despicable Me 3. That's the same beat. And also Seven Nation Army. So if you had any other ideas, I'd be happy to do a little demonstration of those. So these aren't drum covers. They're basically to help my students. And then if anyone else finds them, you can learn these songs because they're all like really fun songs to play. And I think really focusing on the quarter note beat really helps your drumming a lot. So have fun with it, and we'll see you next time.